So here is the new Skyline merch that just came out today, and it's pretty cool. Let's see what we got. We got Magic in the Air and See the World from Above, and we got this for $10.
Yeah, that's not bad for two of them.
No. And the shirts aren't bad either. They don't feel bad.
Got a nice tumbler.
Yeah, nice tumbler right there. Let's see what.
Yeah, there. But you know what? I will say that I wish there was a flip lid on it.
Yeah. The mug is super cute. So you got Pluto, Mickey, Minnie, and Chip and Dale for $20.
Now this actually, I think $22.99.
I think it's too much. New hat.
Oh, I do like that hat.
Oh, I like the Skyliner print underneath it.
Anything on the back side?
This says Walt Disney World. And that one doesn't have a tag. They want this. $27.99. Yeah, that sounds about right.
About typical for a hat.
And here's the new Christmas ornaments. So we got the same prints as the mug. And we got our Star Wars one right here with Chewie, C-3PO, and BB-8. And then a Toy Story one. And these all run for about $27.99. And then Mystery Box pins, which have all, let me focus on that. There we go. All the different Skyway rides. And how much is that going for?
$20. It has
$20. Two pins in it. So these are pretty cool. I haven't seen these in any of the other parks. It's called U-Gears, and you get, there's like the Disney park trains, a monorail, Cinderella's castle, and the just a generic castle, a Disney generic castle. And I believe, so you go and build all these, and they run for $80. That's a little steep. I mean, I will admit they are pretty cool looking, but $80 is a little steep for me. So today's the opening day of the Skyliner, so we decided to grab a pin to celebrate the occasion. And so let's take a look inside and see what the mystery pin is. Inside, actually there's two mystery pins. So I'm excited, I hope there's the Stitch one or the Peter Pan one is the one that I'm really hoping for. So let's hop on in.
Those are great.
So, nice packaging. You're good. Packages are hard to open. So we got Stitch, which is cute.
Yes.
Looking.
Show that there. Let's take a look here, nice and close here. Oh, that's awesome. And that's what it actually looks like on on the Skyliners as well.
Yep. So these are what the windows look like on the Skyliners. We saw them moving today. And then we will open this one up right here. Oh, wow, they're a lot easier to open than maybe.
Fingers, come on, Haunted Mansion.
Oh, well, seriously.
That would be amazing.
Oh, Peter Pan.
And Snow White.
Hey, that's all hey, right.
You we know got what? Snow White looks a little odd in it. I will say that, if you look closely.
Let's take a look here.
Yeah, but those are the two we got. Both purple. So we are between like the main road in Hollywood Studios and then the Primetime City Diner. And if you want to see some old school MGM, there's a Who Framed Roger Rabbit's like out print and then Eddie Valiant thing. Very old school MGM there. These are pretty cool. You can actually get the dice from a Han Solo's ship. And these are good quality. I have some that I actually keep in my car window. And they're $14.99. I can't get anything to focus on price tags, but they are pretty cool. $14.99 for them. And they're heavy and good quality. Star Tours time. Oh, photograph time as well. I hope it's a lovely flight to C-3PO. I really hope, oh, that's not a good sign that there's smoke coming out. There's a Jawa in that bag.
It's good.
And also, there was the Indiana Jones reference on there.
Because you never see Han Solo.
Han Solo.
Just them first. Oh, we'll come in later. Yeah. All you two.
You go ahead. This is fun.
We just got to meet Olaf, and he gave the warmest of hugs. And also, he has the nicest smelling photo op I've ever been to. It's like, it smelled like Christmas in there. I have no idea why it smelled like, maybe it was for him, but it smelled great in there. It was really funny. I was like, I want to be in here all day. And there was no one in line to go see Olaf. We walked straight in to say hi to him. Warning, don't pull rope. If I know anything about Indiana Jones, that means, oh.
Sorry for an artifact down here.
Oh, sorry about that.
50 years of sorrow.
Oh.
Before the destroyer of this vessel.
Oh. All right. Well, oh, and I broke it. It broke. Whoops.
My featured screamers. So let's have everybody stand here on the trapdoor. Yes, yes, trapdoor. I'm going to go down the line. Just tell everyone your first name and where you're from.
I'm Jake, and I'm from Utah.
Action! And come up nicely done. Let's have a round of applause for the first group. That's how you do it, all four of you. I'm going to send you to the top of the stairs.
Thank you.
Just got out the Indiana Jones stunt show, and that was incredible, a once in a lifetime opportunity. As you can see, my hair got a little messed up from it, but I was actually in it. That was awesome, so fun. The outfit was a little warm, I will say that, but that was so much fun. I've never done anything like that, and both me and my dad were in it, which is even the crazier part. So really fun. If you guys ever get an opportunity to actually be in the show, do it. You have to be 18 or older, but if you're ever doing it, just go try and do it. It's so fun. And it's a whole different experience. And maybe come back and watch the actual show, because it's a little hard to watch it from being an actor in it. So we are at Docky Bay 7, and we just ordered our food.
Sorry, it's really loud.
It's really loud in here. It's very, the atmosphere is great, but it is loud in here. So I'm gonna try to read these names off. They're kind of hard to say because they're Star Wars names. So let me pick that up. And I got all this food off the mobile order, which was very handy. So let me hurry and look these up. This one's mine. It's the fried Ango Tip Tip. And it's a fried chicken, vegetables, potatoes, and herb gravy. And then yours is, let's see what hers is. As a Yubship shrimp noodle salad. And it looks pretty good too.
And the big bonus right now is it's air conditioned. We will take that for air.
Yeah, it's very air conditioned in here. And this one was about $15, and this one's about $15. But it looks pretty good and pretty unique to the land as well. And you get real silverware here too, which is nice.
Silverware, yay!
So let's dig on in. And as you can see, the meal was fantastic from both of us. This is probably like one of my favorite meals I've had in the park. It was completely worth $15. The gravy they had with it is fantastic. It's a herb. I've never had anything like it, and it was fantastic.
Okay, so we just got both our milks. We got blue and green. I'm kind of nervous. That one smells really good. That smells like green pebbles. This one smells weird. This one smells weird. So I want to start with the green because blue is the classic, so I'll start with that. That's actually really good. The green's... It's like an icy, almost. I wasn't expecting that to be good. I heard gross rumors about all these. So fun. It's like a milkshake. I don't know how to describe that flavor, though. That one tastes more like a milk base, but... It's not near or bad. They're both really good. I like both. Green's my favorite though.
It does smell different, but I think I like the blue better.
Really? And green's my favorite.
Right here. I'm
blue? Alright. So in the future, I think I went by both of them at the same time. And it was weird. I wanted to see what the two flavors would taste like together. So, and it's nasty. Don't mix the two flavors. It's okay separately, but together. But it was weird, after like some time, the blue one was tasting better because I had one in both hands just walking down. And I don't know, I think the blue one started tasting better. I think it was too much of the green one at some point. Also, quick turnaround. It's the Rocketeer, right there. A quick throwback to MGM, but yeah. Weird flavor. Here we go, on to Fantasmic. I just saw my first Disney cat. I'm very happy I saw my very first Disney cat here in Florida. I've seen them playing Disneyland, but they're very hidden around Florida. And we finally saw one, a Disney cat. Yes. Fantasmic time. Let's go. Thank you.
stomach. You don't get us wet. Oh, the audience is soaked. Oh, there he is. On fire and moist. We smell like smoke and water. So we just got done with Fantasmic. I know we're not in Fantasmic area at all. We're on the complete opposite side of the park. But this one, I love the music because it feels like the original, but also it's really weird because it doesn't feel like the original at all. Like the Pocahontas scene I think is really weird and I don't really like it personally. And you get a lot more wet here. Like, we were like taking a shower there, and then all the ash falls on you. It was kind of weird. Kind of weird. So we're gonna go into the collector shop. I don't know what his name is, but the collector of this land, and check him out. There's the man himself. It's pretty cool. Whoa. Look at him go. It's the K-292 droid, but she's a lot taller than you expect than the helper droids from the first one. I'm sorry all the Star Wars people I'm making cringe, but those are what I know them as. There's other ones, the medical droid. It's kind of cool. And then you got these two droids over here just interacting with each other. Let's see if I can grab a look at them. There you go, you got the BB droid and the R2 unit. It's pretty cool seeing them interact. Like, you don't realize how big BB-8 is, so he is ginormous. Oh, he's looking at us. He knew we were talking about him. Oh, I know, don't give me that sass. All right, go on. Watch out for them. They're making sure everyone leaves. Yeah, he's telling you to leave. So that'll do it for our day here at Hollywood Studios. It was really fun today. Got into the park a little later than I usually like to, but besides that, it was fun. I mean, look at how cool that view is. I mean, you can't be argue with that too much. So we are like, there's no one here. This is so rare. Like, if you look behind me, there is absolutely nobody. It's really cool. You can hear all the sounds that this land has that you normally don't hear. There's so many different sounds. So many different sounds. But I'll catch you guys in the next video tomorrow. Okay, bye. I know Muppets Land is usually dead, but this is ridiculous. There's no one over there.